Pim, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and everywhere else that we're possibly being broadcast on. I am Future Pastor Clay. Men of Word is a movement, man. Men of Word is Men of Word is really about men and women learning to love God, learning that the love of God is all you need. This is the Vegas edition of Men of Word. I am currently in Vegas. Had a great vacation time with my best friends, man, guys that I was literally in kindergarten with. Guys who are all grown now, and you know, some guys that I haven't seen since, we haven't actually been all together since senior year of high school. And man, I really appreciate the connection, the friendships, the love that's built and birthed over a whole lifetime of just knowing each other. The tears that were shed this week, man, the arguments, the fun, you know, the laughs, that stuff was not only fun, but a privilege and honor to be with some men who love each other genuinely, not a homosexual type of love, but a genuine love that says, bruh, whatever's going on in your life, I care about it. I not only want to know, but I want to see whatever I can do to help your situation, man. I'm trying not to be in tears, because I am the crying one, I guess, out the group. Or me and Lil Greg. But either way, the scripture for today is coming from Job, the 42nd chapter, all right? Verse number 10, just real quick. It says, "And the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends." That's it, really. I found myself over this week in the midst of foolishness, in the midst of everything, I found myself praying a lot. I'm praying for my homeboys, you know? It's one thing to be with guys, to know guys, to be connected, to talk to guys. But when you're sitting down with guys in an environment where it's, you know, it's just y'all, man, you get to talking about, you know, what's going on in guys' lives. Not just the highlights, but the, you know, the lowlights, the rough times, the tears, the fears and frustrations of men that you've known since you were a boy. I found myself praying and crying a lot, not in front of them guys, man, but to the side. I found myself I found that I have been failing my friends. I found that in order to truly care for people, to really, really show that you love your people, you gotta pray. See, the things that we really care about the most, we pray for those things. Those relationships, those people in our lives who we are truly, truly concerned for, we gotta pray for those people. The scripture said that the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. The harsh reality of a black man, or a man, a woman, the harsh reality is that we're dealing with a lot of problems, a lot of internal issues every day, every second. We're dealing with those things. And so often our issues, the heap of trouble in our lives, clouds our ability to truly care for our friends, the people we look to and we're disappointed in when things are going on in our lives. We're disappointed if they don't come to our aid. We're hurt if they're not by our side. But in all actuality, when nobody else is around, our true love, our true show of love, it'll be in our private times alone with God. In our moments when nobody else is around. And instead of crying out for myself, Job is dealing with a lot of loss. He's lost his entire family, all his money. He's physically messed up. He's beat up. He's messed up. But God turned the captivity of Job. He changed the situation. He turned the mess and the madness in his life when He quit looking at his own situation. Not looking at himself, but he quit looking at his situation and began to, inside himself, say, yo, I'm looking at my friends, and although I'm messed up, I'm realizing right now that they too need some help. They too need some touch. They too need some healing. So I wouldn't be worthy of calling my friends, if I didn't pray for them. And the fact that I don't pray for them enough now kind of hurts my heart. So the word of Men A Word and Emotional Richard Claymore is that you pray for your friends, man. We say we care. We say we love you. We say we're willing to be with you. We're willing to be around you. We're willing to hang out or turn up with you. But am I willing to go to God on my knees and say, Lord, help my nigga? Am I willing to say, God, I know we usually talk about my stuff and my mess and my situations, but not today, Lord. Today, I just want to pray for my boys. Peace, love, and soul. I am Future Pastor Clay, and this has been A Word. Vegas edition.